What's up, you guys? Today I have my highly requested handbag shopping spree video from my trip to Paris earlier this year. This was pre-COVID, early February, before it hit globally worldwide. Today I wanted to review all the purchases that I got during this trip, show you guys what everything looks like, and then at the very end I'll talk about the details of my personal experience with the VAT refund process. Huge disclaimer, this video is purely informational. I had so many different questions, so I wanted to do a comprehensive video to answer everything that you guys had for your own personal purchases. Not trying to be insensitive in such a difficult time, so I just want to make that disclaimer. Starting with handbag number one, the very first store we stopped at was the Louis Vuitton flagship store off of Champs-Élysées. I really wanted to buy my first Louis Vuitton bag from the store, and it was just so beautiful and gorgeous on the inside, and I really had my heart set on the iconic tote, the Neverfull GM. I ended up getting the classic monogram, but I was really debating on the checkerboard. The interior of this bag, I got the neutral beige. What I really love this bag for is traveling. I end up carrying a lot of extra things, even just an everyday tote where I'm carrying clothes, excess items. I find that this is just the most perfect size to fit everything so comfortably. And the fact that the straps are so freaking sturdy seriously makes it the tote of my dreams. You got the leather pulls on each side to shrink this up to be a nice square shape. And then you have a secure clasp here to cinch things up in the middle. The only real downside to this tote is that it doesn't have a secured zippered top, but we'll get to my other purchase later. The interior features a zippered pocket on the side, and then you also have a chain strap embedded on the inside, along with what I think is one of the best features, the matching zippered pouch. Now, to maintain the shape of this bag and all the bags featured today, I purchased some custom felt organizers. These not only retain the shape to keep things looking nice and crisp, but it also helps to organize the vast cavern that is this big old tote. This one that I have here features a lot of interior pockets along with secured removable zippered midsection, and I love this one because I just got the matching beige to match with the neutral colors of the inside. Easy to clean, forever classic, durable, and just highly, highly functional. Now, obviously, I haven't done any traveling recently, but I find this to be even helpful for daily errands if I have to carry extra clothes, anything to tote around in excess. This is just so perfect. It's gorgeous, and I am especially gonna love it during the fall and winter season. For my petite frame, it definitely looks a lot larger, but I bought it for more of a utility purpose. In the future, I think that I would definitely consider the MM middle size and the damier patterns. And moving on to handbag number two, this is the second tote that I purchased on this trip, and I really feel like it rounds out all of my tote needs. This is the Artois MM tote from Goyard. I for sure wanted to buy something from the Goyard store, and after I really decided on having the oversized GM bag from Louis Vuitton, I said this would be just the perfect smaller MM size. Great for daily use, but also just a little bit smaller and proportional to my body, especially for the days I don't need so many excess things. I originally walked in the store thinking that I was gonna get the St. Louis tote. That's the classic that everyone has. I for sure wanted this dark black color with the tan trim, but the second I tried on the Artois, I was like, this is the one. A few things that really changed my mind. The actual construction of the canvas is a lot sturdier. It definitely feels thicker, but still very lightweight. The actual handles felt slightly thicker and longer for a comfortable shoulder wear. The bottoms, as you can see, has these leather caps to protect the edges and the corners of the bottom. And then the best feature and the thing that I was missing in the GM tote is that you have a full zipper top for security. Another thing that was different is that instead of getting the matching pouch inside like you do with the St. Louis tote, this one features an interior pocket that's nice and sleek and hidden. And when you open the pocket, it's lined in that same Goyardine canvas and the inside. Overall, in terms of durability, structure, and what I feel will be great for wear and tear in the long term, I would get the Artois every single time. I think in terms of like the look and the feel, it definitely still feels like the St. Louis tote. And in this guy, I also have a very similar felt purse bag compartment. I find that the interior canvas feels like a typical beach bag and could get stained very easily, so I definitely like to keep this in the bag forever. And of course, the Goyard pattern is just so classic and gorgeous, and the camel and the black white tones is like the perfect neutral, but gives a little extra to your outfit with the geometric print. Between these two totes, I feel like I have my designer tote needs covered. They're both neutral, classic, timeless, the logos iconic, And I feel like between the two sizes, zippered and open, I really have a well-rounded options. Moving on to handbag number 3, I purchased this at the Celine booth at the Galeries Lafayette. This is, of course, the Celine mini belt bag. I love this bag and the design. I find it to be just like the perfect minimalist, no logo, gorgeous in-between handbag between like my large totes and my mini and micro bags. It's got this gorgeous like trapezoidal shape. If you can see the profile, it's got a very large bottom that narrows to the top. I find this taupe color to be so perfect, like the nicest soft neutral that looks good with warm tones and cool tones. Some of the features I love about this bag, you not only have a top handle to hold it in the crook of your arm, also your hand, but I particularly love this strap because it's a nice short strap that feels very comfortable on the shoulder. It hits really nice for my petite frame. Even though this is the larger size, this strap allows it to not drag too much. It's almost like an elongated shoulder strap. The back of the bag features a zippered pocket. Then of course you have the iconic belt in the front, but the thing that's a little bit finicky, which I'm getting used to, is the actual flap. It's a downward pull to release the clasp, and then you're able to keep it hung over open like this or tucked back in. On the interior of this bag, you have to be very delicate in my opinion. Everything is lined in a nice soft suede. The only organizational things that it comes with is a suede back flap that features 2 exposed pockets. So just like the other bags, I had a custom felt organizer for this bag. I have that same triangular shape. All the hardware is a beautiful gold, and you also have 4 nice raised gold feet on the bottom to protect the bottom of the bag. This bag to me is a great filler in my bag collection. It's not super small, it's not crazy big like my tote bags, and to me the design is just a timeless beauty. And speaking of beauty, I want to thank today's sponsor, Function of Beauty. Function of Beauty is a customizable hair care and body care system. All you have to do is fill out a 2-minute quiz outlining your hair type, hair goals. You can even choose your color, fragrance, and also the intensity. Personalize your ideal formula. You also get your name printed on the bottle. The formula I created achieves my hair goals, deep hydration, color protection, and just a beautifully cleansed scalp. The thing that I really love about these formulas is that there's no parabens, sulfates, GMOs, or toxins. It's 100% vegan and cruelty-free. I also use their custom body wash that's made with moisturizing ingredients and follow up with a custom body lotion. I also use the leave-in treatment. This is so essential for extended hydration past the wash. The great thing about Function of Beauty is that they're delivered straight to your door, meaning you don't have to leave the comfort of your own home, and it even comes with some cute little stickers. If you're interested in trying Function of Beauty, you can get 20% off your next order by following the link down below in the description box. Currently available in the US, Canada, Great Britain, EU, Australia, New Zealand, and more. All right, jumping back in the video, I have handbags 4 and 5 here. I bought them both at the same time at the Givenchy store off of La Montagne. I had this mini Antigona bag on my wish list for so long. I was just waiting for the perfect neutral color, and when this camel beige came up from spring this year, I just knew this was the one. Everything from the shape to the hardware to the strap and the top handle, I love everything about this bag. I have this bag in the small size, in the black shiny leather, and so that really had me excited for this mini size for everyday use. The zippers on the Antigonas are so thick and heavy and sturdy, and there's just a really cool locking mechanism for the crossbody strap. The interior of the bag almost feels like a little doctor bag or a bowling bag. You can fit way more than you think in here, and it actually comes with a couple of open pockets and 1 zippered pocket on the inside. For this one, I kind of had to scrunch the purse organizer on here, but it definitely fills out the bag. Even though this looks very structured, there's a beautiful softness and bounce back to it. It doesn't feel stiff, and the sales guy that I was working with, he was just so hell-bent on me buying this scarf. And at first I was like, I don't know. But after he tied it on here so beautifully, I think it gives it such an organic touch to this bag. And I've been loving it for the spring and summer. I think it's so cute and adds a little something extra to this. And then the second bag, this was an impromptu purchase. I was looking for kind of like an elevated fanny pack because I've been loving just throwing that on for daily errands. This just checked off all the boxes for me. I think this is actually technically a belt bag, but I'm able to kind of like have it as like a truncated shoulder fanny pack. This bag is so sturdy and heavy duty because of the crinkled shiny leather. And then the hardware is just so gorgeous. It's bright, it's gold. You have this removable kind of like round carabiner here so that you can adjust the chain so it could be tighter or looser. The actual leather strap is so thick, it's soft, it's pliable, buttery and gorgeous. And then the actual zipper pull is a thick grosgrain type of ribbon with leather tabs on the end for a secure finish. The interior is just big enough for my wallet, my phone. I find this to look so great for every day. Functional, cool, not too gaudy with the logo. And this is one thing that I really love about all these Givenchy bags. There's a really nice usefulness and practicality to a lot of them. And then for the wallet breaker, handbag number 6 is going to be the Chanel Small Classic Flap. This is the caviar leather. I actually have a whole dedicated video on my purchases from Chanel. I'm gonna link it right here for you guys so you guys can get the in-depth deets. But long story short, I ended up buying a wallet on the chain while I was in the store and I highly regretted it. Throughout the day, I was trying all these other purses that had so much more functionality and I went back to the store and traded it out for the classic flap small and I'm so glad I did it. I love this size, particularly for my petite body. It fits all of the essentials and a little bit more. I don't know if it was true, but they said that this one is very hard to find, especially in this caviar leather. All right, we got the classic details, the chain leather strap that can be used doubled up or singular for a longer shoulder strap, the back slim pocket, front pocket, interior pockets with a lipstick holder, the zipper for the love notes. Thank you guys for letting me know. And then here I also have an interior felt organizer. It's really less of an organizer and just a simple felt liner. It's already a pretty tight fit in here, but I find that this is just gonna help add some extra insurance to make sure I don't damage the interior. This fits so perfectly nice and snug. It just really helps to retain the shape of this bag long-term. Classic, timeless. I think that there's a little bit of a price jump after I left in February, so I'm really, really happy that I snagged this one up. And then the last handbag I have is from Saint Laurent. In terms of a mini crossbody, I wanted to check out the Lulu Toy crossbody bag. I know this is a classic mini size quilted crossbody bag that's beloved by lots of people. A nice starter designer handbag. I absolutely love the envelope flap, the chevron quilting, and that nice cute square shape. It's puffy, it's adorable, and I really was only gonna get this if I saw a unique color that I typically didn't see in the States. And this nice, soft, warm nude stole my heart, and especially with the silver hardware. I have so much gold hardware. The silver really changes it up. The interior of this bag features two main sections. I'm able to fit my cell phone in one, my wallet in the other very comfortably. And you also have an integrated zippered and open pocket on the inside. The thing that really adds to the daintiness and cute little marshmallow effect of this bag is a nice slim crossbody strap. I do wish it was slightly more adjustable, but overall, this one was it. I know this is a mostly handbag video, but I wanted to give a quick shout out to my favorite wallet that I use every day. This is the Saint Laurent zippered coin purse. I've really downsized on my wallets the past few years, and I really like to opt for something that is exactly this shape, kind of like a credit card, and the zipper allows me to get things so easy and fast, but also provides really good security. I'm able to fit this in my Givenchy belt bag, any of these bags, it slides in perfectly. You got the beautiful Yves Saint Laurent logo in the front, and this shiny, smooth-like leather actually has really held up to the wear and tear of daily use. Okay, so now that you've seen all of my handbag purchases, let's talk about the VAT refund. Big disclaimer, this is the first time I've ever purchased anything luxury or designer overseas. In fact, when I was planning the trip like 6 months prior to us going, I didn't even realize you can get savings from purchasing a designer handbag in its country of origin. Doi! So at that point, I was like, okay, this is gonna be a nice portion of the trip. I'm gonna save, I'm gonna get my French designer wishlist bags in France so I can save on import duties that I normally would have to spend if I bought it here in the United States. I started reading tons of articles and blogs of everyone's experiences. It seemed like the process was pretty easy, but throughout each article and the things that we heard along the way, we had a lot of mixed messages, but at the end, I got all of the refunds that I was expecting, so I'm just gonna share with you guys my personal experience today. And to timestamp this experience, this was early February 2020, so of course, things can change, travel restrictions, percentages, depending on where you land, where you come in, like everything is of course subject to change. So just heads up there. On top of saving on import duties by buying the bags in the country of origin, French designers in France, there is the VAT refund. If you are not a citizen and you are visiting the country and are going to be buying things in said country and go back home, you are eligible for what's called a VAT refund. VAT stands for value added tax, which is different to the United States, which uses a sales tax system. Now, there are different VAT rates for each country. In France, the VAT rate happened to be 20%. However, what you actually get back at the very end is around 12% after all the administrative fees. Basically, the rules in France at the time we went is that you need to spend about 175 euros in a single day in a single shop. So there's some stores like the big department store, Galeries Lafayette, which has tons of vendors within that shop, and everything you buy within that big department store will count towards that 175, with the exception of some retailers like Louis Vuitton, which prepares their own tax documents and is not included in the 175. So it gets a little tricky. So wherever you go, make sure to have your passport on you. Basically, we'll check out, they'll write up the receipt, they'll take my passport, get all the information down, and prepare the tax documents. Pretty much every single store prepared all the paperwork beautifully, explained everything to us, and handed it off, with the exception of Galeries Lafayette. Since you're buying so many things from different vendors and shops and designers within the store, there's a main hub area where you come in and bring all your receipts, and it's just so well moderated. There's people speaking different languages, getting all your purchases together so that you have one pamphlet with all of your Galeries Lafayette purchases all consolidated, which was really nice. So as you're shopping, gather all your paperwork, do not lose anything, because when you get to the airport, that's where you'll file the tax forms, within the customs desk or the Pablo kiosk, which seems to be the easiest way to do so. When you get to the airport, you're gonna scan all of these through the Pablo machine kiosk. So you'll go beep, 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 it'll validate it, it won't validate it, I'll get to that in a second. So when we went, and all the designers I showed today, there seemed to be two main companies that were processing all of the tax forms on the back end. There was Premier Tax Free with this white and green, and then there was Global Blue with this bright blue pamphlet. I believe Chanel and Goyard were using the Premier Tax Free, and everyone else was using Global Blue. As you can see, way more Global Blue. That seemed to be the majority. So the main difference between the two companies that we noticed is with Global Blue, there is a subsequent mailbox that you have to drop the physical paperwork into after you scan. With Premier Tax Free, supposedly you just have to scan it, get it validated, and then you don't have to drop it off in the mailbox. So the complicated thing that we were the most stressed about is we had half of the people tell us that you need to process all these forms at your last layover before you leave the EU. Then we had the other half saying, no, 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 if you have a layover in Heathrow, but you're not leaving the airport, you're not staying for vacation, you're literally just going through to get home, do it here in Paris. So we were really struggling on what to do, but we were really stressed out about flights being delayed, us not being able to get the paperwork, not being able to find the right location, being in the wrong terminal. Like, Heathrow is a massive airport, so we just thought we'd err on the side of caution and just do everything in Paris. We had an early flight, and we were also really freaked out because from everything I saw, the lines are crazy long in these customs lines. So we got there at 4 o'clock in the morning, and we just thought maybe the kiosk would be open. It's a machine, is it open 24 hours? That was not the case. I believe it opened, it was either 5 or 6 a.m. We basically just sat there and waited on the floor. And as the machine kiosk was turning on, also there was a physical person at the customs desk to help us out. Got to the kiosk, everything was very self-explanatory. Basically, we had all our stuff prepared. Jeremy was just filing the envelopes, putting everything in to seal off to drop in the mailbox afterwards, ringing everything up. So the one hiccup, and I hope my memory serves me right, the Chanel purchases were the highest ones, and that was the Premier Tax Free, which supposedly you don't need to drop in the mailbox. However, when we scanned that sucker, it showed up not validated. It was a red mark. Everything was green and smiley, except for this guy. So what we had to do was we had to go to the physical customs agent, who I'm so lucky was there so early in the morning, and he checked over the documents, gave it a physical stamp, and then said, okay, drop it in the mailbox. I'm assuming that because the kiosk machine didn't register it immediately and smoothly, we had to physically drop this off in the mailbox because it had the customs agent stamp of approval. That seemed to be the only hiccup, but my only advice is to get there as early as possible, have all your documents ready, have your passport ready, all of the discounts that I received and the times that I got them, so you guys can see like the delay from date of purchase. I have that down below in the description box for you guys to check out. So that leads me into the next part of the process, which is getting the frick home. home. The biggest thing that we did was we organized all of our luggage so that I can take every single handbag with me physically on the plane to take through customs and show them what I purchased. I bought like this little mini duffel bag, and then I stuffed all the tote bags into each other and just tried to make it like a, you know, nesting doll. And here is where I think it gets really complicated and mixed for a lot of people. From a lot of the blogs I read, people were not charged duties as they entered back in the United States, but I think that is very, very gray area depending on what airport you're coming into. So we declared everything on our sheet of paper, and when we got back over here, I had everything prepared for the customs agent here in the Denver International Airport. I presented the papers, I said, this is what I purchased, here you go, here's all the bags. And then he said, oh, he's like, did you bring wine? And I was like, no, I just bought handbags. He goes, okay, stamp, you're done. He couldn't care less, okay? I acknowledge, I think I got really, really lucky. I think this seriously depends on the airport that you go through, the timing, like, I really don't know, but from what I've read, there was a lot of people that didn't have to pay duties when they got back to the country. I'm just sharing what I experienced. So that's what happened with me. I cannot guarantee that with everyone. I hope that it's as smooth as possible, of course. All right, you guys, that pretty much does it for today's video. I hope that this was informative and concise enough to answer the bulk of your questions. Thank you so much for tuning in. I love you guys so much and have an amazing day. I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye.